see, that would be like the perfect place, but there's too much in the way, actually. I don't remember going over that bridge. Or like traveling down this path. I'm sure we probably did, but let's do it again, just to be sure. Oh, okay, that's probably why. There's a foot out. Okay, so it's right there. Oh. Okay. Obviously, just continued on the path where I needed to go. This like points over here, which makes me think we need to be looking like this statue possibly. But I'm unsure of a way up there. Parkour adventure? Nope, we're falling off the world. Do I pass any interesting statues? Nothing out of the ordinary. The only one that was... I mean, that one's quite interesting with all like the weird stuff in its legs, but well, the only smaller one that I've passed is this one coming up here, which has got the flame, or the shard with the flame on it. the shard, not flame. Thing. I called this one out. I called that one out the first time I came past it. So, yo, Dark Soul, thank you very much for the follow, buddy. Appreciate it. Welcome, welcome. That like the star is going to be a right magical mystery tour. Dare I even say it, like the might even like be over there on the tower. Good luck with the job interview tomorrow, Pierce. Okay, so I'm gonna ask a question, and I just want a simple yes or no answer to it. Is this star obtainable before doing the Golden Gate puzzle here? Thank you. Yeah, it's not gonna lead anywhere though, is it? I'm not cheating. I'm just exploring the limits. I 100% would not love to stand here. Ow! But the exit is right there. Wait, how do we actually get to this exit in this puzzle? It looks like it's behind like a normal gate. I promise you, Evan, I am not cheating. I am simply exploring the bounds of the map. Okay. Oh, I'm not locked into the game, it seems. Oh, hey. Don't mind if I do. Okay, know where this driller is. Oh, really? I honestly thought it was going to be in plain sight. Okay, so I'm going to go to the tower for now. This doesn't make sense to me either, like this. Why have we connected something here? Thank you. And the reason I say that is because I kind of feel like we need, I said this in the last time, we need like an activator there. Oh, no, that would make sense, actually. So we get an activator from somewhere, from behind the thing. That's it. Yeah, we get the, so we need to find the driller to get the activator. Get the activator, point it to there, and then somewhere on here, potentially. Maybe we need to go on that behind there. Maybe we need to find a way up to there. Okay, so that makes sense now. That makes sense as to how, why we need that. One mystery solved, at least. His flame, whatever, whichever one you are, because I can never remember. I can guarantee that's 100% not the way you're meant to get up there, and there is probably a much easier way to do it. Hello. Didn't know that fan was there. I kind of feel like, given like the sheer verticality of this map, it would have been nicer to have like a few more fans dotted around, unless I just like missed some of them, of course. Wow. Sure. I guess maybe there are a few more than I realized. For the first time I've activated it without stopping it? Really? Huh.
To create, to understand, and to transform, these are the greatest acts of humankind.
Okay. I guess there's loads of areas like this that I don't want to go down there. I guess the giveaway is like the particle effect, right? I had noticed the particles before, but I just didn't think anything of it. Thank you. All right. I'm going to go and do what I said I was going to do. We're going to go and activate the tower. The reason I was going to do the tower in the first place, though, was because I thought it might have something to do with that star that we just got, but clearly it wasn't, so... I caught my eye. All right, pizza time. Who's ready for some pizza? What variety of tetrominoes did you have? Let's go and activate the penultimate tower.
A long time ago, the Sphinx asked you about my story. You said that hope may still be found if we are willing to look for it. And you were right. Hope is not gone from the world. Some small part of it still survives. But it is not in the flame or in these towers. It lives in the hills and the forests, in the rivers and the seas. You were given a world full of hope, creature of clay. It is yours to protect. Then remember what I've told you, and do not lose hope.
I will not lose hope. To there, Evan!
So, Melville, what do you make of these beams? Do they seem safe to you?
Nothing is really safe. You could kill yourself with a fork, and I'm sure someone has. But anything can be used safely if you choose to.
I see.
Quite interesting, like, that his name is Crier. He was a journalist, and all I think of, like, is a town crier. My old English times. just used to, like, proclaim different bits and pieces in the middle of towns. About Cryer or about this little area that I've found down here? That's out of bounds. We need to find this driller. Problem is, with this area being so vast, it might take a while to find. Plus, I'm not even sure, like, what's the best place to start looking is. Grab yourself a coffee, guys. Could be here a while. Come and save me from the what now? Oh dear, LB. You went there. I mean, my gut instinct kind of tells me, or says to me, it's got something to do with the big statues, but I can't be sure. So is that the puzzle that I got stuck behind? Yeah, it is. I want to get up there. How do I get up there? Go higher and then drop in from above. Yeah. Alright, let's get on this fan again then, and we'll fly across. Hopefully I can remember where I wanted to get to. Though. That's where I want to get to. Primal grunt there. Doesn't look that steep from back there. Making sure that they have I found the Stratton area yet? I know they're somewhere. Clearly I've missed a few strands though. I've only got 8 and this is obviously our 11th area, so I
this.
I'm pretty sure I picked up in the first time we came through here. That one. Up the stairs we go. This is a pretty sneaky place. I would have been a good place to hide it. Unfortunately, though, me thinking it and it being a reality are two completely different things. I'm not sure I've been up this path in its entirety. Back here. Not really where I wanted to be. I just saw something out of the corner of my eye there. I was hoping, praying. It's more frustrating because I know what I need to do to get the star, but I can't do it because I haven't got the right things. I almost kind of wish there was like a quick travel to puzzles once you like solve them. We also need to get on top of there. We wanted to get that shard. easier way to even do that. Regrets to going that way too much. Yeah. Get me where I wanted to go. Don't go any further, I'm just gonna have to backtrack again. I'm gonna fall down. Know what'll happen. Read the future. I mean, My hunch is it's on one of these statues or on an area where one of these statues leads. I just can't prove that. Because every time I try and like investigate one of these statues, I fall off. Plus, I don't like getting too close to the edge. Like that, then you end up falling way worse than you anticipated. Or you just end up doing that, and because every surface is like ice, you just slide right off. Yeah, that's one thing, I guess. Part where you're playing hot and cold. Yeah. Puzzle skip and a trapping situation. Speedrunners can thank me later. It's not really a puzzle skip though, because like I've just proved there, you can get caught in there with no way out, I guess. Again, though, I'm just looking for a way to looking for a way to get some extra height or get a different position on somewhere. But I know, deep down, this isn't going to be what I need to do. More likely than not, I'm going to just end up getting trapped somewhere. Like here. Okay, every time I did that, I walked on the left side, not the right. Any reason? No. I think I went towards the left just because that's the direction of the statue. Oh my goodness. That was subtle. That was subtle, LB. Alright. I mean, I guess that makes sense, because it makes sense for it to be near the puzzle that you have to use to... Yeah, because everything's around here, isn't it? Well, the other one's a bit further down, isn't it? Yes, the next puzzle, but I guess it makes sense with that being there. Okay, so... That's opening a bit. All right. Driller has been released, finally. Jeez. Just gonna work out the other 2,953 steps to get the actual star. Here's the question, and I think I know the answer, and I don't like the answer. Are these things height limited? The answer is yes, you can tell there. So, the next question is, where is the activation spot on this statue? Although it will appear, won't it, if I get close enough. Yep. Wow.
It is not the voice of God that a prophet seeks in the desert, but the silence of man.
It's pretty cool. I was worried. I was thinking like that we'd have to activate it at the top, where we would normally feed the laser into. So we're finally done with West 2. Well, I say we're finally done. I don't know if we found the Stratton thing here. We found that last stream or not. But I'm happy to leave this area. I can find my way out, but I can't. It's over here. Yeah. All right. The final area, West 3, the High Plains. Let's go.
We're getting closer. I hope Byron is still okay.
Prometheus seemed to think so. Let's hope he's trustworthy.
Let's hope. Sarah looks cool. Sup, Cryer? Alrighty.
Another remarkable structure. But what can its purpose be?
Actually, I can answer this one. In the files 1K downloaded, there's a design for a launch pad for space vehicles. This is about 90% identical.
Ooh.
Is it functional?
I don't think so, not if the inside is like the other towers.
Wow. Imagine if it worked. Imagine if we could go up there. I mean, the star is not the top of the tower. Although, that would be cool too.
From within. Jammer connector. No. Do that though.
Athena and Cornelius called what they were doing the Noema Project. But in 1K's vision, they just called it the Machine. Because when you strip away all the fancy rhetoric, that's all it is. It's not a source of meaning or purpose. It's just another machine.
Just another machine. Wow, are each of the puzzles in like one of these areas? It's pretty neat. Chicken flight. It's two things. Thank you. I mean, my initial thought was to... Oh, I got it. So, what we do here is... leave. Makes sense. Is there even a future? Looks like a lot of people are getting excited about this, how things are going to change, but all I can see is another repetition of the same mistakes. Ecocide, hubris, self-destruction. Why would anything be different this time? How about we go what Pandora said? You know, hope. Hope's inside of us all. We've got to have hope, right? The faith was not having faith the whole point of what Athena experienced with Elohim? And what wasn't the stupidity of faith confirmed by the whole founder nonsense? We need faith in humanity, not individuals. But Athena's experience simulation was questioning. Not total, I am still out. Faith is like technology, depends how you apply it. I've never heard of it that way. So you mean faith is a tool you constantly choose to use? I guess you can apply faith to things that deserve it and things that don't. I mean, you can apply faith to... Well, to be fair, you could apply... Sorry. Or speak to me, which is extremely surprising, to be honest. I always thought faith was just a way of giving control over yourself. Maybe I need to reconsider some things. Thanks, 1K. And welcome. Ruins or something over that. Bit of a small puzzle, quite compact. Nice and compact, nice simple puzzle.
The scale of it all is truly breathtaking.
It really is.
But is it a human scale, or is it so enormous that it can only alienate us? Humans have always been happiest in small communities.
Small town paranoia. Isolationism and peasant mentality. Great for burning witches, not so great for personal freedom.
Ever the pessimist?
In the simulation, I found myself thinking how hard it must have been for Alexandra to die without knowing if her sacrifices were worth it. It seemed like a tragic end to an inspiring, meaningful life. But now I realize, her whole life must have been a struggle. To maintain that faith in humanity when so many people around her insisted that humans are evil, worthless, when they were so lost in self-hatred that they would call their own species a virus. How did she do it? How did she maintain her faith when they were so determined to hate themselves? So determined to reject every solution, every analysis, every step towards controlling the forces that were causing their problems, when they rejected even the concept of progress itself, and then patted themselves on the back for it as if that was original. When I look at the archives now, all I can see is that their leaders were short-sighted idiots and their intellectuals were unimaginative cowards. All they could offer people was a downward trend. Fewer rights, fewer freedoms, fewer resources for anything that mattered. They must have hated Alexandra and everything she stood for. So how? How did she have so much faith?
Yeah. I mean, she was obviously dedicated and believed in what she was doing. I think that's why, you know, when you believe in a cause, then you do have that determination and faith to carry on no matter what is going on around you. So I guess that's why.